Oh baby, look what we have here. Folks, this is a second generation Cobra Angel LED. These things are stupid rare. Very, very rare. And this one is done in a blue brushstroke anodizing pattern, so gloss finish. It's a black base with silver and blue brushstrokes on it. And there was different variants of this pattern. There was a yellow, a green, there might be a red. I'd have to go back and check my pictures, but this anodizing pattern was very reminiscent of that late 90s, early 2000s golden era of paintball. So it's awesome. You don't see too many guns today in this brushstroke pattern, let alone gloss. But yeah, so maybe they'll bring it back. Who knows? Anyway, so this was, as I said, Cobra's second generation Cobra LED. And the first generation was more of a super light-esque milling pattern. Whereas on their second generation, they switched to their signature windowed breech block, which is pretty nice, along with some other body cuts and whatnot. So let's just go over those real fast. Hopefully I can remember all this stuff. So just real quick, this is what I'm thinking is a transitional prototype from their first gen to second gen. And the reason why I say that is because this one, the sight rail is a slightly different length than the other second gens that I have or have seen. The other main giveaway is on top of the breech block, there's no Cobra coin or jewel, and there's also no recess for said jewel or coin to sit in. The other thing is on the breech block itself, Cobra, like Adrenaline, they would put their own serial number in addition to the WDP serial number, but this one doesn't have the Cobra serial number. And so, I don't know, I think it was a transitional prototype for Cobra to go from the first gen to the second gen. And I think it just turned out so well, they were like, all right, this is it, let's do this. And then the ones after that, they made slight change to the sight rail. They put the jewel on top as well as, you know, the serial number like they did with the first gens. But hopefully that makes sense. If you have any questions, just let me know. Anyway, so for the milling on this gun, they took the long sight rail from the stock WDP LED and they milled it down. On the breech block, there's sort of this general oval milled into it. There's the windows, as I mentioned previously, and then there's these four vertical teardrops, which is, it's a very classy pattern. And then on the front, if you remember the WDP LEDs, it's like one big tube out front. And so Cobra, they did almost like a feather light mill or super light mill on the front, and then they taper it up to the feed neck with sort of a, I don't know what you want to call it, like an arc pattern. Thought that is really nice. Hopefully you can see that. I think that's about it in terms of the Cobra milling. So the backstory for me with this gun, I picked this up in 2011. I got a tip from one of my buddies and I was like, you know what, I don't have one, really want one. And so I picked it up and it was missing a couple pieces, needed rebuild and sort of restored. It came with this Era mod already on it, as well as this Palmer's LPR. I had Tim rebuild the LPR. I went through the whole gun, rebuilt it, tuned it and whatnot. And I decided that I wanted to go for more of a modern take with this gun when I restored it. So I really like 16-inch boomsticks when I'm playing. And so I decided that I was going to go with a dye titanium matched boomstick. So this is a front tip matched by Caustic. And then it's affixed to the dye or the titanium boomstick. So these titanium boomsticks, I don't think they were out in 98 or 99 when this gun was released. If they were, Cobra Noradrenaline was putting these on their LEDs. So anyways, really wanted the 16-inch matched die titanium, so I put that on there. Kept, as I said, the LPR on. I added the little blue hose up front. Then I added on these snake 45 grips. I know some people like hate that, but I don't know, I feel like it goes with the theme of the whole like Cobra thing going on. These triggers, these were like really expensive back in the day. The little snake triggers. And at first I was just like, okay, this is sort of gimmicky. It's a really short trigger, and if it's a two-finger trigger, I'm not a fan of like the short ones. I like the long Cobra ones that maximize the full trigger guard area. But I will tell you what, this is probably one of the fastest triggers that I've shot. I don't know if it just pairs well with my hand, but I pull it on top of the hump, so right there, as well as right on the bottom, and I can walk this thing like super, super fast. You'll see in these videos, it's a monster of a gun. We'll get to that in a second. Anyways, back to the modernization of the restore. I decided to go with a Cobra Indestruc matched detent, because I really wanted to play with this gun, and if I used a force feed loader, that would, you know, help with preventing the double ball thing going on. I think that's about it. Oh, I added a blue LED bulb lens cover to go with the blue theme, and I think that's it. This gun comes with the custom cut Cobra bolt. So that's this guy here. These bolts are super high flow. So before the, what was it, like new designs bolt, before the soft face bolt, you had that bolt. And you could legit gain 25 to 30 feet per second from switching from the stock bolt to that bolt, which was pretty interesting. So this gun came with the high-rise feed neck. I kind of like it. I don't know. It's just more real estate to put an awesome anodizing pattern on. So it's got the Die-Fang trigger guard. These are really nice for if you actually want to play with the gun, because you can walk the trigger super easy without it your fingers getting all messed up and tangled. It does still have the original matching trigger, so that would go in there. And when I got the tip matched to the gun, just the tip, sorry, I had to, I got a Cobra volumizer matched to the gun. And so if you know anything about these old Cobra LEDs, most of them came with the matched cap volumizers, those generic looking things. But I decided if I'm going for sort of a modern restore, I was going to go with the new sort of LCD style Cobra volumizer. So can't cheap out with that. But yeah, I usually play with this setup. I put a milled down hammer in this gun, and because it has the Era mod, I think that adds a little bit more volume in front of the valve. So when I was tuning this gun, I was able to get it up to velocity using that, I think it's like an 18 gram stain. But yeah, this thing, the performance of this gun, this very well could be the best high pressure angel that I've ever shot. It is a monster. Like, do you remember in 2003, 2004, when everyone was going to Timmy's and you could hear that noise of, it just sounds like someone's just cutting people in half with a chainsaw? That's how fast this gun is, and it's effortlessly fast. You know, how do I want to say this? It's effortless to get it shooting that fast and that smooth. I don't know if that makes sense. So, but yeah, I'll post some shooting videos of this. It is super, super fast. The people at the field all thought it was on full auto. But yeah, super, super fun gun to play with. If I'm playing walk-ons with this gun, I would just, you know, I'd send out like 20 shots real fast. I wouldn't just sit on the trigger and blast people, but I did want to capitalize on that increased smooth rate of fire. I don't know if I mentioned this, but the general consensus is there was approximately 25 Cobra Angels ever done. So that would be the group of 25 would include the first gens and the second gens. So that's a very, very low number, stupid rare number. So there's only like 4 people that own these guns. So yeah, hard to come by. I was, you know, lucky enough to pick up this gun early in my collecting career. And so yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. I hope I covered all the bases with this gun. It's been a while since I've gone over one of these guns. Usually I'm doing the, you know, adrenalines or the stock or the WDP milled guns. But yeah, super sweet gun. Definitely a classic from the golden era of paintball. Thanks guys. Stay tuned for the next one. Thank you.
Dug in.